Many of you have asked for a video dedicated to electronics for a fixed-wing drone. I have prepared a series that will guide you through the entire set of essential equipment, helping you understand its principles of operation, configuration, and installation. This is a fairly extensive topic, so I've divided it into a few episodes. Although the knowledge in this field is widely available online, it's often scattered across various sources. I understand that learning requires time to search for and organize this information. In this series, I aim to consolidate and balance this knowledge, not diving too deeply into details, which you can explore later, but presenting a comprehensive overview of electronics for drones. Before we delve into the electronics required for building a fixed-wing drone, meaning an airplane with autonomous capabilities, let's discuss the basic setup of an RC airplane. We are considering a basic 4-channel airplane configuration featuring one motor, ailerons, elevator, and rudder. Of course, there are other configurations such as multiple motors or different tail setups, but these specifics will be covered later for individual aircraft. For a basic 4-channel setup, we need a servo for each control surface, motor, ESC, RC receiver and RC transmitter, and battery. That's essentially all that's needed for manual flight with an RC airplane. However, to turn it into an airplane with autonomous capabilities, additional components are required. At the minimum, you will need a flight controller, which is the heart of any unmanned aerial vehicle, and a GPS module. Beyond this, there are various additional sensors available to perform extra functions, though they are not strictly necessary. We'll discuss this later. So, what is a flight controller? A flight controller is an electronic device that manages the airplane's flight, ensuring stability and controlling maneuvers. It does this by collecting and analyzing data from sensors such as accelerometers, gyroscopes, GPS, compass, and others. The flight controller is hardware in the form of a PCB that incorporates several key components. First of all, microcontroller. This is the core of the system, responsible for data processing and controlling other FC components. It analyzes sensor data and sends output signals. Modern flight controllers typically use STM32 microcontrollers from STMicroelectronics. These are widely used in real-time data processing applications, automations, and of course, drones. They support various communication interfaces like I2C, UART, CAN, and USB, enabling integration with additional sensors and peripherals, which we'll discuss later. Microcontrollers such as the F4, F7, or high-end H7 are commonly found, differing mainly in performance and processing power. For basic setups, budget-friendly F4 controllers are usually sufficient, though F4 controllers may gradually be phased out as newer models become the standard. Now, let's move on to the built-in sensors. First, accelerometers measure linear acceleration along the airplane's free axis, helping determine orientation and movement in space. They also detect gravitational acceleration, aiding in roll and pitch detection. For example, in level flight, gravitational acceleration is measured only along the z-axis. When tilted, the gravitational vector distributes across the x, y, and z-axis. Using trigonometric calculation, roll or pitch can be determined. Now, gyroscopes measure angular velocity around the airplane's free axis, indicating how quickly the airplane rotates around x-axis, x, y, and z. They detect rapid rotational changes but cannot detect sustained inclination. In practice, a combination of accelerometers and gyroscopes is necessary for complete and continuous spatial orientation and motion data. This combination of three gyroscopes and accelerometers is often referred to as an IMU, inertial measurement unit. FCs are also most commonly equipped with barometers that measures atmospheric pressure to determine flight altitude. Next, memory, often called the black box. This memory can be built in or take the form of a micro SD card storing flight logs and parameters for post-flight analysis and diagnostics. Voltage regulators and power ports, which stabilize the voltage supply to the FC from the battery and distribute it to various outputs such as powering servos and other components. Let's now briefly describe external modules connected to the FC. The fundamental external module is the GPS, essential for navigation and enabling autonomous functions like waypoint-based lights. GPS is also most often paired with compass, specifically with magnetometer. It determines magnetic heading. As I said, it's often integrated into a GPS module, although separate GPS and compass modules are also available. In addition to the essential components such as servos, ESCs and RC receiver, you can also connect an FPV camera and VTX if live video feed to goggles or a monitor is desired. Both analog and digital systems are available on this market. Digital systems have become increasingly popular due to their reduced cost compared to the early days, and significant improvements in performance, particularly in signal range. It's also worth mentioning about analog OSD. This module overlays flight parameters and telemetry data onto video feed from the FPV camera. Most FCs have a built-in OSD for analog systems, but some models lack this feature, requiring an external OSD module. In contrast, digital systems transmit OSD data directly from their VTX to the receiver, so they not need this module. Let's also talk about a few additional sensors that are often used in fixed-wing aircraft. First, pitot tube that measures airspeed and is especially useful for fixed-wing aircraft. While not mandatory, as airspeed can be also estimated using GPS ground speed, it provides much more precise readings. Next is LiDAR that measures distances with laser light, offering high accuracy and short ranges. It can be used for obstacle detection or precise altitude measurement above ground, especially for autonomous landings. Drones can be equipped with a wide variety of advanced sensors and modules depending on specific needs and applications. These include vision cameras, thermal cameras, sonars, air quality sensors, thermometers, hygrometers, transponders, redundant barometers, GPS units, compasses, and more. Such additions are typically specialized for commercial or industrial applications, tailoring the UAV platform for specific tasks. And now it's time to discuss about communication interfaces. Understanding this is essential when working with flight controllers, as you will encounter these terms often. First, UART, a serial communication interface for bidirectional data transfer used to connect the GPS modules, telemetry modules, or RC receivers. Most FCs have multiple UART ports. Next, I2C. This interface supports communication with multiple devices on the same bus. It's typically used for low bandwidth sensors with as compasses, barometers, or digital airspeed sensors with pitot tubes. Now, CAN bus, a high-speed serial communication protocol enabling real-time data exchange between multiple devices on the same bus. It can connect ESCs, GPS modules, compasses, barometers, airspeed sensors, LiDARs, servos, and receivers. Not all FCs support CAN, and is rarely used in basic hobby setups. SPI, a fast communication interface used for sensors like gyroscopes and accelerometers, as well as for memory, for example, flash modules or SD cards, and also OSD modules. ADC. ADC converts analog signals into digital data, used for monitoring battery voltage and current, telemetry signal strength, or airspeed from an analog airspeed sensor. USB. A USB allows traditional wired communication with a computer, essential for tasks like firmware updates and configuring parameters. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth enable wireless connectivity to a computer or mobile apps, allowing for remote configuration and parameter adjustment. Now let's talk about the outputs from the flight controller and two important terms. First is PWM. PWM is a pulsed analog signal where the pulse width encodes information. It's used to control servos and ESCs, which control motor speed. However, PWM can be replaced by D-SHOT in motors. D-SHOT is a digital communication protocol for controlling ESCs and is faster, more precise, and supports telemetry such as reporting ESC temperature and RPM. To summarize everything discussed, I've prepared a complete diagram of the flight controller, which shows the available communication interfaces and outputs, as well as the main components connected to them. We still need to talk about the types of flight controllers and the distinction between copter and fixed-wing versions. The market offers flight controllers specifically designed for copters and fixed-wing aircraft. However, this doesn't mean that the FC made for copter cannot be used in a fixed-wing or vice versa. The design of FCs is optimized for the intended application, so if you're building an airplane, it's best to choose a flight controller designed for that. There are several key differences between these flight controllers. Fixed-wing FCs typically include a PDB for distributing power and connecting separate ESCs. They also have, of course, a rail with outputs for connecting servos, equipped with a built-in 5-volt voltage stabilizer, making servo connection seamless. And last is form factor. Fixed-wing FCs are often rectangular, while copter FCs are square-shaped, designed to fit standard drone frames with mounting hole patterns. Most of the flight controllers we've discussed usually consist of bare boards, often requiring soldering and lacking protective enclosures. In contrast, controllers like CubePilot or PixHawk come in enclosed, pre-assembled units that don't require soldering. These are plug-and-play and work well for fixed-wing aircraft, though they are significantly more expensive. Such controllers are commonly used in professional platforms, and for basic setups and airplanes, there is no noticeable performance differences compared to cheaper FCs. Finally, we need to say something about the software and firmware. Firmware determines an FC functionality. Popular options include Autopilot, iNav, and Betaflight. Here's a brief overview of each. Autopilot is a robust firmware used by both hobbyists and professionals. It supports a wide range of functions, from basic flight modes and FPV operations to advanced autonomous missions, including auto-takeoff and landing. It's compatible with various airplane and copter configurations. Betaflight, primarily used in FPV copters, is tailored for manual flying, such as racing or freestyle, but autonomous functions are minimal and not well developed. iNav, a middle ground between Autopilot and Betaflight. It supports configuration for both copters and fixed wings, and features a simplified interface similar to Betaflight. However, it doesn't offer as many options as Autopilot, and it's sometimes less reliable. Features for fixed wings are still being developed. For most fixed-wing applications, Autopilot is the optimal choice due to its versatility and reliability. This firmware is widely adopted by drone enthusiasts and professionals worldwide. In this series, we'll focus on installing and configuring Autopilot. In addition to the firmware in the flight controller, we also need a ground station. This can be a computer or a mobile device with an appropriate application. The most popular ground station with full functionality is Mission Planner, available for Windows and Mac OS. Mission Planner allows you to connect your FC, configure parameters and settings, plan flights, monitor flight data, or control the drone in real time if a telemetry radio is on board. There are also other options available, like Q-Ground Control, which is compatible with both computers and mobile devices. However, it's somewhat limited in terms of functionality compared to Mission Planner. There are no obstacles to using it, but in this series, we'll focus on Mission Planner, which is the most popular solution. These are the basic principles of electronics of a fixed-wing drone, focusing primarily on the flight controller and its compatible components. In future episodes, we'll build a complete basic electronic setup step by step, including selecting and assembling the FC, performing necessary soldering, connecting GPS and other components, and uploading firmware and performing initial parameter setup. In the meantime, subscribe and check out our website where you can purchase 3D designs of our aircraft. Also, feel free to join our community groups on Facebook and Discord. And let me know if this introduction has been helpful and if my approach to explaining this topic suits your needs. See you in the next video.